What's happening? What's happening, family? How you doing? How you doing? All right, all right, all right, all right. Yes, it is Wednesday. I am the Metaphysical Morpheus, aka Rev Shock, and I am back on a Wednesday with the man, the physicist, the myth, the legend, Ron Spears, part two in a four-part series on moisture. And I'm so excited. Last week he just tore it up some more. And guess what he's getting ready to do today. So welcome back to the platform, First Frequency of Oneness, Shock Metaphysics, Ron Spears, the physicist, and the crowd goes wild.
Yeah, I'm starting to see a different side of the physicist in this next couple weeks.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. But it's beautiful because, you know, we were talking in the green room about relationships and, you know, we don't talk about it enough. And we don't have scholars like yourself that can bring those relationships into focus from a spiritual as above comedic process. So mm-hmm. What you've done with the spoken word and moisture is absolute genius.
Oh, no, I appreciate it. And the really cool thing about it is, you know, a lot of this is stuff that I've written years ago,
mm-hmm.
you know, and now that I'm really, really studying the African sacred science, it's just really coming together on a different level.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And so that's the beauty of the journey is of higher consciousness.
Mm-hmm.
Written some poetry back younger. They write in a journal and stuff like that. But you know, most people just do that and just sort of hold on to it or just they don't do anything with it. You know, that's their decision to make. You know? But I'm just blessed that I've got all stuff back with lens, the stuff that I wrote 10, 15, 20 years ago,
mm-hmm.
different. And it's.
Well, we lost Ron Spears. All right, he was having some audio issues. Let's see what's going on here.
You know, just keep writing. If that's something that you do, you know, keep doing it.
Well, we just lost you, brother. And then you came back on, and then you froze, and then your audio got garbled. As you know, we are being targeted. Yay! I love it when we get targeted.
I saw a little something too.
Oh, okay. You saw something on your side, camera. Yeah, because you're right now frozen, and choppy and blurry, and I don't know what's going on. So, are you running any other processes currently on your computer? That's taking up internet time or bandwidth.
The internet went out a couple of days ago, and the Comcast folks came, not for the house, but just for the whole neighborhood. You know, I'm hoping that there's not any residuals of that.
Gotcha. Well, as you know, we've had some serious storms here in Cali. So the internet hasn't gone out, nor has the lights, but I've noticed there's just a bit of a shift. But right now I got a very strong signal.
Yep.
So I don't know, but yours now all of a sudden is because you're usually like your camera and the screen and everything usually looks like mine, really strong and crystal clear. You're kind of blurred right now. So I'm wondering if they've reduced a little bit of your speed and bandwidth. I'm wondering if that's what's going on. So, well, let's keep trying. So let's move forward. We'll muscle through it. So, you know, the introduction of part one was absolutely amazing. This one is about self-improvement. And so I'm interested to see how do you do, because, you know, when you say self-improvement, it sounds like you're talking about yourself, but you're talking about self-improvement as a unit.
Yeah, there's so much, and I know you understand this as well as the community. It's from self-knowledge to self-improvement. Self-knowledge, I mean, there's nothing more invigorating than getting that knowledge of self.
Sure.
But what do you do with that information? Are you able to use that information to transform your, you know, your level of consciousness? Or are you just basically drunk with the knowledge? And it's not making, it's, you're not translating it into tangible, recognizable, manifested physical realities, improving your quality of life. And that's what I kind of refer to as self-improvement, you know? And so, so that's kind of where this show is kind of, you know, meant to kind of draw that, that journey from self-knowledge to self-improvement, because at the end of the day, knowledge is great, but if you don't apply it, or if you're not able to, you know, apply it to your current situation to improve yourself first, your relationships, your community, the world, then it's just knowledge for knowledge's sake.
It's like buying a bunch of books, not reading them, and just putting them up on the shelf and saying, "Ooh, look at my library," but you have no idea what's on there.
Or even what's even worse is buying the books and reading them. And just going to the next book. Going to the next book.
Wow.
And then going to the bookstore and getting watching the next YouTube video. You know, and you're so engulfed in gaining more and more, because there's so much out here.
You know,
it's so much out here, and it's so much to process. You know, and absolutely. So we'll kind of get into how that plays into moisture in a bit, but it's you know, it's all related. I mean, everything can be life is one big, you know, journey. And relationships, self-improvement is one. And a lot of times you hear this so often, the foundation for any strong, healthy relationship is work on yourself first.
Absolutely.
And so if you want to invite, you know, moisture into your life or basically just, you know, because a lot of times you want people to change you, or you want, you know, it's sort of like, hey, you know, there's one way of saying, because none of us are perfect. And so, and we're always on a process for self-improvement, our journey.
Absolutely.
We should be, right? But we're at any point in time, we're still not perfect. Now, 10 years ago, 10 years from now, you know, and so it's, if you're looking for somebody, or if somebody enters your space that sort of balances out what you know, what you're not strong at, that's a different conversation. That's not necessarily what we're talking about here. You know, I'm talking if you're just sort of weak, if you broke, you want to find somebody rich. If you you want to find somebody pretty so you can have a good looking kid. I don't know. People do different things that is gonna get them all messed up, you know?
Right,
if you
don't
have nowhere to live, you want to find somebody who got a house.
Well, you know, it's also what I say. You don't attract in life what you want. You attract in life what you are. So if you so you have to fall in love with, you have to learn how to fall in love with yourself.
Absolutely. And that's a journey within itself.
Right.
That a lot of folks, you know, don't want to talk about if they're, you know, not on the higher end of that journey.
Sure. Absolutely. You know? Now, I know you have a PowerPoint. I want to send a shout out to Shahid Douglas. I see you out there. Pam, PJ, I love you. I got your email. She's part of our Clyde Winters class. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Anthony Jones, I see you out there. And Recovery, thank you for tuning in, fam. Now, talk to me about this amazing PowerPoint, because you, I ain't gonna lie, man, you put together some exciting PowerPoints. I just love your presentations and what we're gonna be talking about, because also what we're dealing with is we're building up to. And shout out to the folks that are going to be a part. Power 8, my brother Damien, what's going on, my brother? Part of what you're doing is we're building up to a 4-week webinar series, which is starting in February, I believe.
Yep.
And I want to give a shout out to those who've already joined us and signed up. And we want more of you, particularly in the month of love and the month of Black history. We want to make history, and in particularly in that first quarter, within the first quarter of the Gregorian calendar, we want to permanently change the direction of our lives, so we don't keep re-experiencing the same reality over and over again from 2022 and beyond in our past. It's time for a cosmic break. It's time for a cosmic shift, and the grand rising is the way to go about this as it relates to moisture. And I love how you put the moisture with the R and Ron Spears. That's kind of cool, bro.
Just being my little creative mind, you know. Putting presentations and you know, pop. It's what I do for a living as a management consultant,
sure,
and a change agent, and imagery is everything, mm-hmm. Especially as you know from our ancestors with the Medu Netter, who mm-hmm. you know, mm-hmm. words carry much more meaning than. I'm sorry, imagery carries much more meaning than blah, 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 words, all words, mm-hmm. words, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
so that's kind of even one of the topics today, the written word versus the spoken word. But there's always a visual dynamic in presentation, but more so getting your point across to folks, especially things that are not as simple to talk about.
Sure. You know,
our ancestors were advanced beings,
mm-hmm.
and left some serious. They use a lot more of that brain's capacity than many of mm-hmm. us, unfortunately, mm-hmm. leverage and utilize.
Facts. You know,
so this is just sort of from self-knowledge to self-improvement is kind of the title for this one. But this is really just, you know, in preparation for the moisture. And we'll get into moisture from a definition standpoint, you know, because yes, it's going to grab your attention, the word and all of that. Mm-hmm. And many people may have different definitions of it, but we'll get into it. But the main thing is what I'm so happy about is that it's coming together as sort of my grand trilogy. Okay,
mm-hmm.
and Black Matter Lives is obviously published and out, and the community has embraced it. The elders and scholars mm-hmm. have embraced it, and it's been a whirlwind ride on the different platforms and getting the feedback, you know. And so it inspired the next book, Grand Rising, which you know, mm-hmm. I got maybe two more chapters to write for that. And that should definitely be done in this first quarter. But excellent. Grand Rising is the webinar that we did last month, you know, and man, that went over very, very well. So mm-hmm. I'm on to something. But the thing that I really enjoyed about the Grand Rising, I mentioned this last week, was it was more of a cipher. Yes, I was teaching, I was providing information. But when you have elevated beings and minds on the mm-hmm. call at the same time, you know, a small list, and we can all interact with one another. We're building on each other. And if you remember, I was changing some of the chapters to Grand Rising during
sure.
these sessions because,
that's right.
you know, I'm and moisture, I'm going to kind of do something very well. Number one, we're talking about Black love. So,
mm-hmm.
so
there's mm-hmm.
always stuff to talk about there. You know,
well, that's what I love also about the your process. It's organic, and you're able to shift according to the need of the individuals that are in the audience for the webinar. It's mm-hmm. absolutely amazing. So it's personalized.
Yeah.
You know, and sometimes, you know, people go into these webinar situations and they just feel like the person is just talking at them or to them, but not with them. And it's not experiential. And that's one of the things I love about your style and your process.
No, I appreciate that. And so here's the tricky thing with the moisture.
Hey, Deborah Smith, I see you out there, goddess. Shauna Carter, I see you just came on. Hey, Anthony Jones, I think I gave you acknowledgement. And recovery is Greg West. What's up, Greg? I was just with him last night for the men's ministry. What's up, my beloved? So continue, because I really want to get into this PowerPoint. I can't wait. You know, I'm in class too, even though I know what's going on. It's like I'm sitting here, I'm ready to go, improve my relationship. You know, whatever I can get.
Yeah, no, we're gonna dive into it. Here's the tricky part with moisture. Moisture, number one, was written before Black Matter Lives and Grand Rising.
Mm.
And moisture, as it stands right now, is an audiobook. So it's all spoken word, 2 hours of audio book.
Wow.
So one of the things that I'm trying to decide, and now that's part of one of the things that I'm going to deal with in the webinar, not here in the promo, but in the webinar, is should moisture be a book, or should we leave it as an audio book? Because
there's the community,
so much power in the spoken word.
It is. Community, should moisture remain an audiobook, or would you like to see it in an actual physical book? Let us know, family. Put it in the chat.
Yeah. So, you know, as we kind of go through this, and here's a good example. Last week, in last week's show, we didn't get a whole lot of time to kind of talk about it because it was at the tail end of the show.
Uh-huh.
But we did my you know, basically this was one of my bigger pieces whenever I would go out and perform, was Rise Up. You know, empowerment for our sisters. And
yes,
then, you know, like I mentioned last week, it took me about a year to write Man Up, you know. And so, you know, when I shared it at Grand Rising in that webinar, I mean, you know, the feedback was really, really big, you know. And last week on the show, I mean, you know, the feedback was large there. So that's just sort of an example of there's so much power in the spoken word.
Absolutely.
You know, and so, you know, kind of as we, but I love getting the feedback, because like in for Black Matter Lives, you know, when people write books, you know, they get these big name folks to write stuff on the back, like, you know, Kaba Kamene and Philippe Matthews, you know. But I decided to do something a little bit different or extra, because I did do that. But I added, this was actually, Susan is someone from your show, from audience.
Okay.
Who put a comment in there, and it says, your spoken word resonated with my spirit. My mind and spirit are on overload, and I love it. Your spoken word is spiritually out of this realm. Thank you for sharing the knowledge. You know, and I just thought that was wonderful. And because, you know, people write things and they put stuff out there, but, you know, it might be beautiful and brilliant to them. But when you hear people, and I'm going to share some feedback throughout this show on, you know, how people react and respond to my spoken word. And that's just part of what I really, really love. And that's where, you know, being a part of this webinar series on YouTube. Yeah, you can put things in the chat and we'll click and acknowledge and we can. You know, but in the YouTube, we're all looking at each other and we're having a just sitting in a circle, so to speak, and vibing together, which is a whole different, you know, energy.
Sure.
So again, from self-knowledge to self-improvement, you know, the Sankofa experience is always this, that model that came to me in grad school, you know, where self-knowledge starts the whole process. Okay. And then and then what I did with Black Matter Lives is I tied all of this to the laws of physics. And so in this middle part, spirituality and obstacles and then self-improvement, this is where a lot of our people, we don't get to, we know about the African sacred science, but we also know about the epigenetics and a lot of the things that are operating against us. And we try to incorporate Ma'at in our daily lives, but we end up reverting back to different things. So going from self-knowledge to self-improvement. And I even use the Gagut as part of this whole thing, the IJ, J, you know. So you got the J here, which is the spirituality, and the I, which is the obstacles. So those are the two forces working against you. You know, and then this is the J here, because it's the same J as up here, but you don't have the I anymore. So now you're able to see some sustainable change, because and improvement in your life, you know. And so what You know, so what grand rising is the elevation to our higher consciousness to rise above the three-dimensional limitations to experience fourth-dimensional human experience, because that's when you're going to really, really have the ability to manifest change in your lives. And since we're talking about moisture, you know, when you see life skills, you know, we all have to deal with the different phases of life, you know, the learning phase, the working phase, and the living phase. And most of us are in this working phase, trying to get to that living phase, you know, where we're spending most of our 30 to 40 years dealing with some kind of career, wanting to get married and find our soulmate, have some children, raising children, and the stress that can take on with all the epigenetics that can break up any of those three things, it takes its toll on your health.
Absolutely. So,
you know, the quality of life really gets impacted. But, you know, when it comes to moisture and marriage, you just think that your soulmate, having that partner to ride out life, is one of the greatest helpmates, one of the greatest things that you can have. And so you have an expectation of choosing and marrying your soulmate, raising a family and growing old together. That's the expectation. Mm-hmm. Reality, the gap between, you know, this expectation and our reality is the cause of a whole lot of, you know, moisture in the form of tears. Moisture in the terms of what you probably originally thought moisture is, or thinking what moisture is, right?
Well said.
You know, and so so what we do in the grand rising is, you know, when we talk about Black Matter Lives, right? Lives being that acronym of love, increasing the vibration to disrupt the epigenetic signal. The difference between the expectations and the reality is the reason why we cannot go from self-knowledge to self-improvement. So we, you know, you have to offer solutions. And that's where love, Black Matter Lives. Love is the highest vibration of force. Mm-hmm. Okay. But you have to do certain things to increase your vibration, because you, in order to disrupt that epigenetic signal, that signal is not going anywhere right now. Mm-hmm. So the best thing we have to do is do something that's going to vibrate higher than that. And so that's where a couple of we offer suggestions. Of course, meditation and self-reflection, showing gratitude, because everything is not bad. You know, everything is not bad. We all have had some good experiences that we can show gratitude for. Doing community service and helping others, you know. Positive thinking, you know, understanding the law of attraction and how to use that in your positive thinking. Okay. And a commitment to work-life balance. Don't just be all, don't put all your, you know, all your eggs in one basket, so to speak. You know, so having that balance is very important. Listening to music and going out and dancing, it's just that movement. The power of movement does wonders for our vibration. And then spending time in nature, you know, is something that good, that does good. And then supporting, you know, each other in life's challenges, you know. And so obviously, yes, that's what a soulmate does. But if you're not there, then having the, like you said, these men's ministries, these women's ministries, these support groups, these, you know, just your friends and family network, you know. So those are just things that can really help. But the, you know, the signal interruption, the epigenetic signal, I mean, we know about the, what's pulling us apart, the criminalization and murdering of, you know, the population control with, especially with targeting our brothers. Okay. Mm-hmm. If you look at any music and TV, everything is hypersexualized, right?
Absolutely.
It's going to maintain us in that three-dimensional state of existence, and then fear of commitment. And I mean, you hear all these stories, it's like, man, why would I even, you know, sign up for that?
Right. Shout out to V. Connolly, Vache, I see you out there, brother. Love you, young God. Thank you.
Yeah. And so that's, yeah, I see these comments too. I appreciate that. Much gratitude. And then when you look at dysfunctional relationships on so-called reality TV.
Yes. Like, yes. Yes. Lord,
Is it really that deep?
You know? Right. Right, right, right.
People that are just like, man, that's how I want to be. And I'm just like, really?
You know?
And so, you know, those are just some things that just, you know, we have to pay attention to. And then when you look at Tefnut, okay, which is all about the moisture, right? Mm-hmm. And you look at the Gagut equation, you know, and you know, we kind of teased it a little bit last week, but the Tefnut is basically the comma of Gagut.
Mm.
It's what is the, because see, this is where we get messed up. This is where all the stress is. This is, we're stuck in that third dimension, the IJ, but it's the comma in tensor physics, in fourth dimensional physics, it's the comma that is the transformation. And that the transformation of anything in life begins with water, begins with moisture.
Wow.
You know, and so that's one of part of the role. Last week, I showed the first air, and you see the waves down at the bottom. I got them on every single slide now. Okay, because the symbolism of this new telescope, James Webb telescope, that's out in space now, producing high resolution imagery of deep space. And the first thing, one of the first things they found was the presence of water in the form of waves.
Wow. You know?
And so that's exactly what our ancestors is telling us. And so the water, what comes next is the supernova, the Big Bang, the stars, the formation of the stars and the different images that you're seeing. So yes, we're going to talk about that in the first webinar for moisture, is that the context, divine context of this. And then when you look at the four forces that make up the Big Bang, and you tie that to basically the male and female energy, of what our ancestors did, you understand that this thing does not happen without the female divine feminine principles tied in with our male aspect. And so what I do is I kind of take it one step further, because the Gagut is a rank 2 tensor, but I'm like, I look at this rank 3 tensor, and I see it as that male and female energy that can really, really transform. And so in that sense, I think this Tefnut is the law of attraction, right? And the biggest force that you could ever have is the energy between the male and female. We manifest that right down here in the third dimensional plane, just the energy that we have, just attracting each other and flirting and all of that. Right. But it's the same thing in space, with matter and space, infinity, darkness and light, and hidden and revealed. Our ancestors knew and understood all of this. And so what Tefnut symbolizes is moist or corrosive air that brings about change, creating the concept of time. I mean, that's the context that I'm excited about. And we're going to start the moisture webinar with this. We're not going to spend a whole lot of time on this, because, but it's just going to tee it up as the context, because the first thing you have to do and understand is, you know, to get your mind out of the, I'm not going to say out of the gutter, get your mind out of the three-dimensional aspect of moisture and raise it to the fourth dimension. We have to understand just how bad our ancestors were and
absolutely.
How the energy works, you know.
Ma'at is out there. Womb evolution. What's up, my high priestess? Ma'at and Makaru. Amen. Hotep. She'll be with us tomorrow. She'll be with us Friday. And it's beautiful, because both of you, we got to pull together a webinar series where both of you are working together. Because I mean,
she's not ready for me now.
Oh, you talking stuff. He's talking ish of my aunt.
I know she's Chicago. I'm Detroit. So, hey, we can, you know, we
that's ready. Right. That's right. Midwest is in the house. What's going on now, fam? That's good stuff.
I'm going to try to keep up with her. One of the
keep things- talking. I'm going to run to the restroom. I'll be right back, my beloved. Keep talking.
Okay, cool.
Keep teaching.
So one of the things I want to show first is this, when I did, I always tease and say the moisture came first. I started writing about this, but now once I got into Black Matter Lives and Grand Rising, a lot of the stuff that I wrote is now starting to make sense. And so, I did this spoken word series called The Primordial Waters of Noon, kind of going back to the original aspect of our ancestors in terms of that as above, piece. And I did this, you know, shout out to Chicago, Detroit on that house music. You know, I put a lot of these spoken words. I put that African drum into the spoken word just because, you know, we work heavily on that vibration. And so I did one, and my aunt is teasing me. I'm teeing you up to show you some love. This is one I wrote, you know, kind of dealing with the power of my aunt from a spoken word. Let me see if I have a couple of bars on this.
She inspires me to live life to the fullest. She never lets things get me down. I put my trust in her higher power to keep me on the right path. Her beauty commands attention wherever she goes. Her charming smile wipes away any feelings of self-doubt. My whole attitude changes just from being in her presence. Her wisdom and grace demands my obedience. She taught me the difference between fantasy and reality. Fantasy is all the material things I thought she deserved. Her vision for my life is focused on character and inner peace. Reality is the challenges I must face to achieve her vision. Her knowledge helps me grow wiser as I get older. Just when I thought I mastered her needs and desires, she quickly elevated her standards to the next level. She is shaping the person I will ultimately become. She is shaping the person I will ultimately become.
You know, I had to say that bar twice. She is shaping the person I will ultimately become.
Absolutely.
You know, I mean, that's just the power of Ma'at. Once you get into that fourth dimension and you start embracing Ma'at into your life and into your daily practice and into your consciousness, that's when manifestation and self-improvement can really start. And so, absolutely. You know, that's, you know, and that's just one of the pieces. I have one called Noon Heaven, you know, and you know what Dr. Ben said about heaven, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, God, the black matter, the original woman, the original man, the African drum, you know, it's just next level primordial waters of Noon, right?
Absolutely.
As above, spoken word with that house music. And I see my boy Bruce Bailey on the chat. That's my he does a lot of my music for the house on the house music side here in Detroit. So good to see you on the platform, Mr. Bailey.
Wonderful.
So yeah, welcome. Moisture is a 4-week webinar series, and you know, $69. That's read into that the way you want. If with a third dimensional mindset, but look, I was born on June 9th, so that's my, and on top of that, born in 1969. So that just happens to be the price of this webinar. And 6-9, if you're into the numerology, is high vibration love.
Okay. Absolutely.
Not that three-dimensional stuff that where your where some of y'all minds may have went. But anyway, you know, I do everything in sevens, you know, so seven chapters in everything. His fantasy, her fantasy, flirtation, foreplay, penetration, the afterglow, and empowerment, you know. And so you know, just so you can kind of see the and I ran this ad last week, but this is kind of the promotion that I run for
Love makes the world go round. No matter how busy and successful you are, single looking for love, or married looking to spice up your love life, we all need some moisture in our lives right now. My name is Ron Spears, and they call me the Storyteller. I want to introduce you to my latest spoken word project called Moisture. Now let that sink in for a sec. The Moisture Experience is an audiobook containing 2 hours of stories and perspective about his fantasy, her fantasy, flirtation, foreplay, penetration, the afterglow, and empowerment. Ladies, you can listen to The Moisture Experience alone in your car, on your next airplane adventure, or at home with a warm bubble bath or glass of wine. Or if you prefer, throw on some lingerie, do a little primping, and listen together with that someone special in your life. Now, fellas, pour yourself a shot and let me be your wingman to add another dimension to your relationship. You will thank me later. Moisture contains everything you need to get in the mood, including great music and deep stimulation. Whether you prefer intellectual or just plain raw, trust me, I got you. I look forward to what you have to say about moisture. You can
So yeah, I just wanted to kind of give that promo teaser that I do for
excellent, phenomenal. For
now, kind of getting into. Let me get to this next.
Melvin Wright asked a question. Wait a minute, I just lost it on the screen here. Hold on, let me put it up on the screen. As a matter of fact, he says. Is this the embodiment of first sight consciousness? Absolutely, Melvin. Absolutely it is. First sight consciousness is the highest level of seeing ourselves through our own eyes and seeing our own value and our own worth. And in order to do that, we must see the value in our divine feminine and in our divine masculine, which is the balance of Nunpata and Atum. So yes, absolutely. A great question.
Yeah, absolutely. And that's one of the cool things about, you know, this is going to be a cipher. So yes, the material is already written. It's the spoken word. I'm just going to share it, and we're going to have a little bit of discussions just like that in terms of how that hits you. And let me give you an example, because this is an example here, because, you know, one of the things that we have to do is define what moisture means, right? And that's just exactly where that question kind of came from. But let me give you an example of what one woman said when I asked, because I always ask that question. And I can't make this type of stuff up, you know, and this tells you just about that balance and how we are different. She said, it's a soft feeling within that brings a certain calmness, comfort, and affection towards the one you love, admire, and want to be with.
Wow.
It does not necessarily have to be an entrance for intimacy. It's an entrance into my heart to be filled with him. My heart has been crying for his attention, his affection, his acknowledgement. He's given it to my heart, which has been moistened by my tears. A heart that is open and ready for his penetration into my soul. First, he fills my heart with his love. Then he can fill the rest of me that would be moist for him. I said, damn.
Phenomenal. All right. Now, so
I didn't write that, but that's an example.
As the old timers in the R&B says, wow. Right. That was awesome. Got a question here from African Empress 01. She says, as an African, I kind of think the first people on the planet were thinking about whether or not the sun will return tomorrow, not sexualized moisture. But she's asking, am I right in asking this question?
Not too sexual. Let me read the question again.
Oh, let me put it back up there again.
Oh, man. You know, she's reading ahead. She's reading ahead in my presentation. Like what you was doing last week. You know, absolutely. I mean, that's, you know, if you don't get anything out of this, and keep in mind, I wrote moisture first and then Black Matter Lives and now writing Grand Rising. And so now I'm like, man, when you look at the promo that I just, and that's why I ran the promo that I did, because, you know, you think it's all about that aspect, the sexual energy of now as I'm, you know, writing and vibrating on that higher frequency with Black Matter Lives, I'm starting to see it was not just about that, or never just about that. As a matter of fact, that's the lower level frequency of it. Right. And I'm going to get into that in this, you know, in this presentation, and really into it next week. Because, you know, I'm just throwing some lobs out here now. But next week, because, you know, we're dealing with defining moisture and his fantasy and her fan. Next week, we're going to get into some of the flirtation and some of the more, you know, impactful things. But no, I'm glad you asked that question, because it's you know, it's exactly where I'm going with this.
Mm-hmm.
And so another one, you know, in Black Matter Lives, you know, the whole chapter 7 of Black Matter Lives is several different poems that I have written, including poetry on love and marriage. And this is one actually, you know, and I have to kind of tell a little bit of the story behind this one. It's the first one here. It's just called Girl, You're So Sexy. You know, I never intended for this one to be published. This was just sort of like, you know, I was just starting to get into spoken word, and I was just like, well, let me do something for my lady, you know? And, and it was like a her birthday type of poem. And I ended up performing it at a spoken word venue here in Detroit live with her there, you know? And so everybody was just like, oh, you know? Since it was such a personal piece, I never really intended on publishing it, you know? But you know, the feedback was so good. And I put it up on SoundCloud, and a lot of people really were I mean, it's actually the my most listened to piece on SoundCloud. My most listened to love poem on SoundCloud. So I'm gonna play the full one. Are you seeing the SoundCloud thing now?
Yes.
Okay, cool. I'm just gonna run the first minute and a half of this one. You gotta come to the webinar and buy it to get the whole thing. But anyway, and then you're going to love the music too, because I'm going to get into that, you know, more so next week. But the music is all jazz music. House music is the primordial waters of Noam.
Girl, you so sexy and fine, I just had to let you know. Please allow me the pleasure of breaking you down from head to toe. Now, I've had a secret crush on you for just about all of my adult life. You are the type of woman that any man would love to make his wife. Now, I've seen your hair go from long to short and then back to long. The different and sexy looks make my attraction for you so strong. Remember the wet sets of outfits and braids and perms and even all the hair pieces. With all those unique personalities, my lust for you actually increases. Now under your hair is your greatest asset, your sweet yet complex mind. Most of the guys in your fan club never get past your sexy behind.
Yeah, I know you hate that movie.
The dimensions of your personality validates all the laws of attraction. The way your presence lights up a room, every man or woman stands up at attention. Now, I've noticed your pretty face for a long, long while. That smooth brown color, those alluring eyes, and that award-winning smile. Your voice can be silly, soothing, and sensual all in the same breath. The words that come out of your mouth are well thought out and in depth.
All right. So like I said, it's just teasers here, you know.
I love it. I love it. I love it. I like it, man. That is awesome.
So, yeah, I mean, you know, all of my poems have a story behind them. And that's where the audiobook gets to be 2 hours long, because I share a lot of the stories. But for the webinar, we're going to break down the lyrics, you know, because you see, I brought out the laws of attraction in that piece, you know. I mean, and I basically said, the way your presence lights up a room, every man and woman stand up, you know, I'm basically saying the dimensions of your personality validates the laws of attraction. That means, you know, as we say, I see you. No, I feel you. You know what I mean? And that's where you know that you're doing. And, you know, when you're in a relationship as long as I met this lady in the 10th grade, you know what I mean? So, yeah, this next week, I think, nope. Yeah, in a couple of days we'll be like 27 years married, but we met in the 10th grade.
Wow.
But anyway,
beautiful.
So that was that piece, but you know, so as you are now starting to get a little bit of a glimpse of how people respond, or what some of my poetry is, these are some of the things that people say about it. And this is kind of, you know, wow, I so appreciate your talent. You just captured every intimate moment and emotion from beginning to end. In depth, erotic and compassionate. You saw it, approached it, wooed it, put your name on it, and I'm loving it. Thank you for sharing your gift with me. So, you know, when you hear people say stuff like that, you know, I'm glad I published a piece like that. That was a private piece, you know, but I'm sure people can identify with that, you know? So, and then another one here, your writing so eloquently put, I can't help but smile. You are such a free spirit. You are intelligent, confident, impressive, positive, and captivating. You inspire me. You give me teachable moments, and you motivate me to reach my full potential. And see, that's where, you know, that's the type of feedback that lets you know that this, see, moisture is not just sexual. It is, you know, and that's and kind of, yeah, you know, so now when you divine the experience, in the third dimension, it's a life force, right? Because that's how life gets brought into this world, but it's also the source of a lot of pain as well. But when you elevate it to the fourth dimension, you understand that moisture is all about love. It's manifesting that vibration of love, or that force of love, at the highest level in which it is designed. And that's to the you know, the question, African Empress question, you know, when you think of it in that third dimension, that's the sexualized piece. But in the fourth dimension, that's where you get into the African sacred sciences and understanding the true love. Love not as an emotion. That's the three-dimensional piece. Okay. This is love as a force.
Absolutely.
And a frequency. Absolutely. And that frequency is visible to others. That's that law of attraction. So that's where moisture takes on a whole different meaning. And so some other things, and these are some of, let me see, this one here I think is, yeah, this is one that I wrote. This is just an excerpt from one of my pieces. You know, it's like we both engaged in deep stimulating conversation. Our vibes connected to solve all the problems of this great nation. You see, she understood that my interest in her was much deeper than the physical. In fact, once our minds became one, she already made love just to our potential. That's how women think different than men.
Wow.
All right.
That's incredible.
We try to spit gay, but you know, where does moisture come from? Between the ears.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
The ears, right? Because you're looking at her, you're like, man, she's cute. Let me see how we vibe and da-da-da-da. And she's looking at what potential do you have in our life? She's thinking like 20, 30, 40, 50 years down the road.
Trying to maximize the next. You're thinking about the here and right now. Yeah.
You know?
That is so true.
Yeah, so that's just an excerpt of one of my pieces. And that's one of the things too. When you look at poetry, it's the written word and the spoken word. And I mean, you know, obviously you write first. Well, you know, there's some gifted folks that be freestyling and doing all kind of, you know, that, God bless them. That's definitely you know, that's definitely great. Put Melvin's comment up, because that's I love it when people, you know, share their definition here. Moisture seems to be when two spirits come together, the boundaries came down and the spirits meld together. You know, now, you know, I'm busy reading the piece. I don't know if that came before, but that's exactly what we just talked about, you know.
Absolutely.
I appreciate that. I mean, that's, you know, that's the, when I talked about the male and female energy of the electromagnetic forces that created the Big Bang, that's how it came together. And so
Absolutely. It's
just a, we're just playing out what our ancestors taught, you know, for the as above piece, you know? And as Power Inc. says, it's the ultimate form of Black love. When you add the Black Matter remix to moisture, but you know, when you look at the written word versus the spoken word, it's a whole different ball game. You know, writing great prose and journaling is awesome, But when, you know, when people read stuff versus when you hear it, it's a very different vibration because it's the spoken word that produces the vibration. I mean, you know, I hate to say this, if it's good enough, if it, words come with vibration. And when your words come from a force of love in your heart, then it has an opportunity to heal, you know? So this was just happened to be a picture of me. I was at a club doing a piece. It was a house music event, and they said, "Ron, just come up here and throw a few bars up here." And so I did that, and the photographer caught a moment where the crowd reacted to, you know, some of those words. And so whenever you go out to an open mic, and you do that, and you see the crowd reaction, it's a whole different vibe, you know. And so the spoken word is, you know, it's not no diminishment to the written word, but mm-hmm. it's the spoken word that really, really is where the transformation is. And so that's why Moisture is an audio book. Ron should drop a love album. Moisture. Have you been listening? Moisture is the love album. It is called Moisture. Okay, so now this is where, and you may have heard this, you know, because there are, and I saw somebody in the comments, you know, earlier talking about, you know, I don't know, demonizing sexual energy or women who have so much sexual energy and society making you think as though that's a bad thing. That's not a bad thing, you mm-hmm. know. You know, we have it too as well, you know, as guys. But when you focus on just the sexual aspect of that energy, then yeah, that's that three-dimensional phase. But when you elevate it to the fourth dimension, and again, that's where Ma'at comes in. Ma'at is in your heart. You're vibrating on a frequency of love. And so that's where all that sexual energy is used for healing purposes. Mm-hmm. And so that's where you can kind of have that opportunity to use this energy. Obviously, you know, I'm married, I've been married all this time, so what am I doing with all this energy? Heal people, okay? That's the use of this energy, right? And so this is a piece, one of my favorite pieces that I've ever written, and I put it in all of my books. It's called Why Do I Write Poetry? And this is just a line from it. I write because, like you, I get confused about the meaning of life. The good times come with great memories, but the bad times come with even greater pain. I often receive pearls of wisdom to help solve this mystery called life from every person I encounter, every book I read, and every place I travel. It's how I process and store all these pearls along with the memories and pain. The memories and pain don't go away. It's just how you process it to find the meaning and purpose I need on my journey for self-improvement.
Excellent. You
know? So this is just an excerpt of a poem that I wrote. Why do I write poetry? And like I said, I put it in all of my books. It's in the introduction to Black Matter Lives. You know, and you see me looking out the wing of an airplane. I mean, you know, like I mentioned last week, probably 90%+ of the poems that I've written were written on airplane rides, up in that altitude, kind of in a meditative state, strapped in, you know. So
excellent.
Anyway, something to kind of think about. And this next piece, man, it's one that the community is gonna love this piece. But what's different about this piece is I interviewed a sister. It's about that healing energy. I actually interviewed a sister, and we spoke for about a good hour, and I just was kind of understanding what her experiences were, what she, you know, what some of her frustrations are, and this, that, and the other. And so this is sort of a celebration of women and what they have to go through, because, you know, despite all they're going through, I mean, man, you look at them and they're just so just badass. And you're just like, man, but you just never know what's going on in her life and what had to go on. So this is just sort of a piece that I did just to celebrate that. And so that's just why this moisture thing is just, you know, that's why you see that type of feedback. But you know, now this is kind of a music video, but if you could just sort of, you know, forget about the imagery and focus on the words, you know, easier said.
When you see that beautiful woman walking by, what do you think to yourself? Okay. After you notice her outer presentation of hair, nails, makeup, clothes, and shoes, after you imagine yourself caressing her curves or spending the night or the rest of your life with her, do you ever think about the pain, struggles, and sacrifice in order for her to make such an impression on you? She may have considered herself an ugly duckling in grade school, but now blossomed into a beautiful swan. Her body may have gone through many changes before filling up that voluptuous vixen that you are admiring. The insecurities that plagued her as a child or young adult have now disappeared, as all you see right now is pure confidence. As she has come a long way since first walking in heels to now strutting like a model on the runway. You have no idea that what you see is a result of both struggle and influence of her mother and father. Her poised posture might be carrying the weight of supporting siblings, parents, and grandparents. You can't see the battle scars that she's either hiding or proudly wearing as a symbol of her journey to success. As you are mesmerized by her strut, just know that she has not been exempt from relationship drama. Whether she desires to get married or failed to sustain her marriage, you couldn't tell by how at peace she is right now. Those compliments you want to share are not even necessary, because all the validation she desires comes from within. So the next time you see that beautiful woman and fall in love with the confidence of her strut, take a few moments to think about everything she had to go through before she got dressed that morning. Don't just fantasize about how you want to make her nipples and your manhood as hard as possible. Begin to appreciate how hard her life may have been and celebrate the fact that so far, she is winning.
That is powerful, brother. That is incredibly powerful.
Thank you.
That's incredibly powerful, family.
Thank you.
I hope I don't get a copyright strike from that music, because I've been getting copyright strikes.
That's my boy. That's my boy.
Okay. Yeah, I've been getting these. They're just threatening me on every level. When somebody comes on and plays music, it's like, I get a copyright strike. But no, that was an absolutely amazing, very profound, and very powerful. Her winning strut. We, you know, this is something that we just need. We need to have this in our homes, in our lives, in our daily lives. Because there's something about the spoken word in the way that you present it is deeper and more meaningful than just listening to, you know, soothing music or jazz.
Right. Absolutely. And you know, and that's a piece, like I said, and that's why I love these webinars, because, you know, you get to interact with folks, because that's where my lyrics come from nowadays. Right. Mm-hmm. Because if you don't want to heal, I've had a different experience, you know, I've had my experience, and now I need to listen to other people and understand. Because when you write, when you have a gift that can heal people, you have to understand where they're coming from and what mm-hmm. their experiences have been, so that your gift can heal others and meet mm-hmm. them where they're at, because that's what's going to help us to, you know, kind of connect. And so that's one of the things that we're going to deal with the, you know, with the webinars, you know, and this is just from a book that this dude wrote. Is a, but anyway, it's interesting, because it's like top needs and expectations in marriage. It's like for women, it's affection, conversation, openness and honesty, financial support and family commitment. And for men, it's sexual fulfillment, recreational companionship, having an attractive wife, domestic support and appreciation and admiration. Now, you know, I've talked with people, and, you know, there are a lot of women that said, you know, that list put me over there on that right side. And and you know, or it's sort of, you know, instead of, you know, 10, instead of 5 for women and 5 for men, it's basically 10 for that male and female energy of what's needed. And you put it in whatever order, everybody's going to have their own, you know, list of 5, so to speak, and whatever order is most important. But those are the types of things that, you know, we need to understand and discuss. And that's where a lot of this, you know, the spoken word comes from, because at the end of the day, you know, we have choices to make. And this is, these are some difficult choices. It's like, you know, do you marry or stay single? It's like choosing to marry means you commit yourself to one person to build a life and share in the triumphs and challenges. Choosing to remain single means you prefer the independence of managing stress and drama. You know, now marriage is tough, but it has the capability of filling our lives with true love and happiness. And staying single can be tough, but it keeps you in control of your own definition of love and happiness. Whichever route you choose, keep the focus on love and happiness. Remember that the grass is not all greener on the other side. It's just different grass. And what waters grass?
Facts. Facts. That in all mind. Facts.
You know, now, here's the other choice. If you're in a situation, you know, do you leave or do you stay? You know, choosing to leave means you can no longer take the drama of your current situation. Choosing to stay means your convictions are strengthening your tolerance for drama. Now, if you leave, you face the uncertainty of what drama the next situation gonna bring. But if you stay, you risk succumbing to your fear over your convictions. The one thing is certain, the world is full of drama. Strengthen your convictions or decide for yourself if known drama is better than unknown drama. You know, I mean,
all facts.
We have choices to make. And so, you know, in this webinar, I just want to get people's reactions and perspective on, you know, on things like this. And so that's, you know, something that we want to talk about. You know, and the last thing that I'll share just for today's promo lesson is, you know, when there's something about that altitude. I was on a project in Calgary, which is in Canada, and there's a place called Banff, which is about an hour north of Calgary. And so, man, I see all these mountains. I'm like, man, I want to go up there and just, you know, experience that one weekend. So, you know, it's like when you think about that third dimension where we're on, it's the attitude, but the fourth dimension is about the altitude. Things change when you're up there. And so that's kind of what the whole point of this. So, you know, I wrote a piece. You get a sit in nature and you write. That's one of the things that I do. Right. And you know, I just kind of, you know, this is not something that I've ever really published. This is probably the first time that I've ever even shared this publicly. But you know, I said mountains are the most majestic, awe-inspiring testaments of the power of nature. Long before we were born, and we'll be here long after we're gone.
Absolutely.
Mountains outlasted all natural disasters, earthquakes, floods, fires, tornadoes, and they proudly show off their scars as a sign of their natural beauty. They rose above the primordial waters, because a lot of mountains were, you know, formed by water, and carved out to be unique and unmatched. Our lives will face natural disasters and many scars. Be like the mountain. Patience is not a virtue nor a discipline for mountains. It's their reality. They are guaranteed to still be standing. And when it goes down, will you? You know, so that's just something that I wrote just sitting up there in nature.
Exquisite.
I know I said Canada. This is Hong Kong here, which is one of the mountains, but the other pictures were from Banff. You know, so it's just you know, when you get into nature and you get on elevating to that frequency, a higher frequency, these are the types of things that come out and you can apply them to life. So real quick, webinar one is going to be February 1st. We're going to briefly get into Gagut 2.0, that male-female unity, just for that context. And then we're going to have a cipher about defining what moisture means for everyone. We're going to listen to some tracks, and then we're going to have a discussion about those. That's what webinar one is going to be. February 8th will be webinar two, and we're going to get into his fantasy and her fantasy. And so we're going to get with the mental side of moisture, again, from a third dimensional standpoint and elevating to a fourth dimensional standpoint. Again, we're going to break down some tracks, and not just my tracks. I'm going to share some tracks from my favorite poets and spoken word artists. And then we're going to deal with that male and female energy, you know, because that's the fantasy is what creates the law of attraction.
Mm-hmm. Right?
And then, you know, that's what the discussion and the cipher is for. And then the third webinar is going to be on February 15th. And that's when we're going to get into the flirtation and the floor foreplay. And that's, we're going to put this into action. Moisture and change, relationship quality, the laws of attraction, the go from the mental to the physical. Okay. And again, we're going to go through some tracks, not just mine too, but, you know, some others. And then have that discussion. And then the fourth and final webinar on February 22nd is going to be on the afterglow and empowerment. And then we're going to basically do moisture in my eye. Basically, hey, at the end of the day, it's all black love and controls change and transformation and time. Okay, so you have to, the time is going to collapse while you're focusing on your energy.
Mm-hmm.
Find that and you connect with it, man. I mean, you will make up that time real quick. So that's where the empowerment side of it comes. And so that's why some other
All right, family, we lost Ron Spears. Hopefully he will be back. He's having some internet connection issues. And we've got, you know, all kind of spammers and things coming on. It's just what happens when you start migrating to the truth, becoming the truth. These are the things that begin to happen. But the beauty is that the links to the webinar, the 4-week webinar series with Brother Ron, is in the description, and you can go there and click that on along with in the description. There's everything Ron Spears that you can experience. So my assumption, okay, I think he's going to try to come back. Let's see if he can get back on here. All right, my brother, there you go. I was just kind of filling in for you. Hopefully you would come back. Are you able to speak and we can hear you?
Okay. Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Yeah,
sorry about that. And I, you know, just want to wrap up the, you know, the at least the PowerPoint aspect of the promo, and you guys get to see all the pieces before it went out.
Yes, we did. Okay, we saw that, and that was great. Now, what you said after that, none of that came through.
Yeah, no, I kind of knew immediately. I knew immediately that, you know, I just was talking about the last thing I mentioned was what you're going to get with the webinar. You're going to get the 2-hour audiobook. You're going to get the matrimony, 7 poems on love and marriage, and 7 poems on the meaning of life, because, you know, moisture pulls all of that together. So,
wow.
So yeah, that's what you're going to get. And now there are a couple that bought the webinar last week after last week's show. You know, you don't have to wait to February to get it. I'm going to send that to the folks who already signed. So as soon as you sign up, you're going to get the 2-hour audio book for moisture. So
wow, that's incredible. 2 hours. Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Love that. Yeah.
So, you know, you got to do your homework before the show.
No doubt.
No, I see some of these comments here, you know, about what is dark matter sound like and evoke? Yeah, I think you just found. But the primordial waters of noon is more on that black matter lives with that house music. But moisture, if you're elevating to that fourth dimension, you're going to understand the healing nature of these words, you know, more so than the sexual nature or the nature of it, you know. Transferring his energy and alchemy. Oh, absolutely. Chemistry, that electromagnetic force is what it's all about. And that's why we are so, you know, that's why we're so, but the state of male female relations right now is so horrible. It's like the positive and positive is repelling so much now. And so that's why the timing of this is so needed and necessary, you know, to at least start to put that energy in there. And that's why I'm so much in favor of the spoken word, you know, as you know, not just the written word.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Well, let's give thanks and give onks to Brother Ron Spears and Amma and the ancestors. Definitely speaks to you and through you and as you in this spoken word. And I love the healing energy. Just hearing you, hearing the music, hearing your cadence, it's so very healing, so very nurturing, and so very necessary. So if you will indulge me, I would like to do our affirmation of power as we close out. My beloved family, I am one with first frequency.
I am one with first frequency.
I am one with the first thought idea.
I am one with the first thought idea.
I am one with the firstborn people.
I am one with the firstborn people.
Therefore, I am one with the only one.
I am one with the only one.
Ashe.
Ashe.
Asheo.
Asheo.
And so it is.
And so it is.
All right, family, you know what I need you to do. I need you to get behind this webinar. Let's see you on the 1st of Feb. Let's see all the love and all the moisture come our way. Let's manifest a new reality. Let's use the law of attraction to move ourselves forward, particularly in this first quarter. So we will not see another 2020, another 2021, 2022, so on and so forth. All right, family, wishing you peace, love, prosperity, and health. My brother, Ron.